wiser feller than me once said, sometimes you eat the bear, sometimes the bear, well, he eats you. That's my story. A story of ups and downs, a beautiful tapestry of battered bruises and untamed beards. Who am I, you ask? I'm the guy who played paper, rock, scissors with the wolf back in one. I swapped saliva with a mind moon goddess and survived to talk about it. I'm the king of Campfire, and the stories I weave are legendary. The story I'm about to tell is a true original. An astonishing trailblazer, if you will. A story of Badlands. 25 years ago, before hashtags and man buns roamed the earth, Badlands was born in what became known as the Tinder Box. Why call it that, you ask? Let's just say fumes, flames, and small spaces don't usually work well together. Or maybe because it sparked more ideas than Da Vinci or Einstein's workshop combined. The most astonishing idea to come out of the tinderbox? What if carrying copious amounts of heft on your back didn't have to be painful? What if hunters didn't have to dread the pack out? Why do they call little candy bars fun size? There's nothing fun about them. Back in the old days, no such thing as a hunting pack. Once saw a hunter move a deer piggyback style. Thought he was under attack by a rutted up buck. I digress. Long story short, old packs were about as useless as rubber lips on a woodpecker. Now, Badlands understood human anatomy. Don't ask me how they got so educated. It's not like they attended medical school. They knew the spine was curved and so are the hips. So why in Sam Blazes were most backpack frames rigid? The goal was clear, make a better pack. Cut and dry, you say? I've never laughed before. Don't you make me start now. Inside the tinderbox, Badlands was born and set a new standard for hunting packs. Tinderbox was responsible for men growing their first beards and for destroying thousands of brave little brain cells. So long, little buddies. So did the gamble pay off? The hundreds of hours huffing fumes, molding foam, sharing a bed with a skeleton pay off? That's another story for another night around the campfire. Until then, remember, a deer will tolerate hearing you three times, seeing you twice, and smelling you once.